Hello and welcome to High Voltages. In the last video, we fed in and fed out the LED using PWM pin and analog write command. In this video, we will be taking digital input and we will be doing something with that. So let's get started. First of all, let me show you what we will be doing in this video. So, this is what we will be doing in this video, and we will be writing the program to run this interesting LED circuit. So let's talk about what we will be using in this circuit. We will be using two LEDs, red and green. And we will be using a switch button to take digital input. And we will be using pull down configuration to put our switch button in working. So when the push button is open, LED green will be blinking, and when the push button is closed, red LED will blink. So what is pull down configuration? Let's talk about this. So now let us talk about pull up configuration and pull down configuration. So here you can see two figures. This is pull up configuration and this is pull down configuration. In the pull up configuration, you can see that resistor is connected to voltage source and switch is connected to ground. And in the pull down configuration, switch is connected to voltage source and resistor is connected to ground. So what happens when switch will be open? When switch will be open, the voltage at L2 will be V minus voltage of resistor. And when the switch will be closed, the current will find the easiest path to flow and it will flow to the ground. And in the pull down configuration, when switch will be on, the easiest path will be towards the LED, so there will be 5 volt or you may say 1, and when the switch is closed, there is no voltage, so that means there will be 0 voltage or you may say low. So this is pull up configuration and pull down configuration, and in our circuit we are using pull down configuration. So now let's talk about the sketch. So now let us write our sketch for that interesting LED circuit. In the setup body, we have to define which pins we are using and for what purpose we are using. So writing pin mode 7, output. We will wire the green LED at pin number 7. Pin mode 10, output. This is for red LED and this is for green LED. And now pin mode 9, input. This is for button as we are using it as input. So in the loop body, we have to tell what we have to do with these connections. So here we will declare a variable integer a, and it will be equal to digital read. Digital read means to read from any input. So, and it will take one input and it will be the pin number. So we are telling the integer variable a to read the read the digital input at pin number 9. So if writing condition to do something with LED, if A, that means that if A is equal to 1, this will be executed if A is equal to 1. If A is equal to 1, digital write (10, 1) delay 200, digital write 10, 0) and delay for 200. This will be executed if switch will be pressed or the value of A will be equal to 1, else, and this will be executed if A is not equal to 1 or switch is not pressed. So digital write 7, 1) delay 200, digital write 7, 0) delay 200. So what will happen if the switch will be pressed or A is equal to 1, red LED will blink, and if not, if A is not equal to 1, that means A is equal to 0, green LED will blink. So now let's compile the program. We have to save it. Now you can see that our program has done compiling. So now let's make the circuit on Proteus. So now, as you can see, we have completed our circuit. Now let's upload the .hex file into the Arduino so we can check our output. So copy the hex file from here. This is the hex file. You have to copy it and then go to Proteus, double click on it and upload it. Now let's run it and you can see switch is not pressed and green LED is blinking. Now press this button and now you can see red LED is blinking. So this is what for this video. In the next video we will be doing something different. Till then, thank you for watching. Subscribe my channel.